Hi, welcome to this episode and something that I feel very strongly about, and that is about the idea of what is the purpose of a class, what is it that you want in your outcome, and what is it you hope for the people who are attending your class. So I want to talk to you a little bit today about goal setting, about theme building, special occasions, and personal growth. So if we're looking at the first idea of goal setting. Goal setting is something that you can do before you start into your classes, knowing exactly what it is you want in your outcome at the very end of a project. So not necessarily just what do you want today, what do you want at the end of the project? The second part is you can set that goal also for the day of what you hope to accomplish. For me, as a dance studio owner, and as a dance teacher, I would often goal set at the start of class, and I would I'd sit in my car while I was waiting to pick up my kids, and I would go, you know, today I want to easily and joyfully create the choreographies required by my senior line of dancers. And that was a very stressful situation for me to make sure the choreography was really strong and it suited the needs of all of the people in the class, especially if there was conflicts between dancers about how they might want to do things. So it was my job to make sure I smoothed all that through. So I would goal set at the start. And as I was saying my phrases, I would do cook's hookups. And you may have remembered that from the last episode, lesson 9, where you cross your right leg over your left, cross your right hand over your left, link up your fingers, and then hold. And so I would say, I easily and joyfully create the choreography I need today. And I just hold on to that vision of what it looked like, what the music was like, the picture I wanted. That goal setting allowed everything to flow for me to be very at ease while I was teaching, but also the material was easily picked up by my dancers. And that was really important. Now, if you're a dancer, goal setting at the start of your class, sorry, cook's hookup would have finished here, and then putting your fingertips together and put them in front of your belly button for the second part. And sometimes I would re-say the phrase. So I might, I've already got that vision in my mind. And so now it's, I play the music, I can see myself moving across the floor, I can see the lines and the patterns that I want to create, I can see the relationships between my dancers that I want to have them experience. And I just hold that. And I could hold it for 10 seconds each of those poses, or I could hold it for a minute each, just until I was done doing my visualization. Okay, so if I'm doing that as a dancer, I'm going into my class, maybe we're back into restrictions and you actually can't get to class. Now you're going to be in your bedroom and you're going to have your camera or your phone set up and you're going to be coming into a class that's being taught online. It's very difficult to do that. It's very stressful. So one of the things about dance is it brings us such great joy. So if we hold on to the joy, and yes, we have all these circumstances we can't do anything about, but we love to dance, and dance fills up our souls and it just makes us so happy. So we don't want to lose that. So what you want to do then is goal set for I easily and joyfully, or I'm so grateful for the opportunity to dance today. And you just bring in a phrase about what it is you want from the dance that you're going to be able to participate in. So as I describe this to you, I want you to think about how you can goal set with your dance so that you're maximizing what you can get out of it, whether you're the dancer, whether you're the instructor, whether you're a head choreographer, whether you're trying to direct a whole bunch of things to happen at one time. This tool is very valuable for dance, and it just transforms the energy that happens around all of the movement. Okay, so let's go to the next topic, which was theme building. One of the things I've always taught with is I've always known what my end of the year is going to look like for a theme. So one of kind of the components that I need to get to that theme, maybe I need to develop the skills in my dancers around their ability to express. Maybe it's sorrow, maybe it's joy, maybe it's relationships with each other. I've already predetermined what I want them to experience and learn, and I've already goal set for that. So when I've come into my class and I have my theme ready to go, everyone can buy into that theme. If we're doing the musical Cats, and we start talking about what it's like to be a cat, what is the experience about it? What would you kind of show off if you were this kind of cat, that kind of cat? You can see how that theme easily builds into what you want to do. So the theme can transform the way that people will participate, the way that people will respond and gain skill, but also for you, the way for you to be focused in on what you're doing. So that leads me to the next part, which is special occasions, because dance is celebrated with milestones, with lunar sequences and cycles, with the equinox, solstice. There are lots of places where it's a ceremonial ritual kind of dance that people do to celebrate a certain time. We have dances at Christmas time. We have dances on Saturday night, on the weekends when people go out and they want to gather with friends. There's so many ways that dance gets shared. And one of the things that I hope I inspire with all of these lessons is to think about dance as something that you do every day and how you use it to celebrate who you are and what you want to do. So if you're starting to think about some of the lessons I've put in, I've been outside, I've played with sand, I've been in the garden, I've been down in the forest, trying to embrace the fact that if you cannot be in a dance studio at this time, you can be dancing anywhere, and it might be in your bedroom, which is actually quite cool because lots of times you have a mirror in there, but you also are restricted in space, and that means you have to be really creative on what you want to do and how you want to feel. So I just want to invite you to think about some of the different ways you could celebrate dance because of what day it is or what activity is happening around us in our culture. So some of the videos that I've shared that I'd like you to watch, I pulled from YouTube, and I pulled them specifically because of that theme. And I'm hoping that's going to inspire you to think how you can take what you know about dance from a studio setting and from a learning a certain style setting and transform that into making it personal for you. That leads us to somatic dance. There are lots of ways that we can experience dance. It's used for healing. In the somatic way, it's about being aware of what everything feels like in your body, how you notice what the movement feels like and where you want to go with it, and what feels good for you and what doesn't feel good for you. And if there are some expressions like sadness, or maybe one of your characters has to cry on stage, then dance is a way for you to bring in that emotion and experience it. Know what it feels like for you. Notice what it feels like when you replace it with joy afterwards. And being able to transform how you feel and what you're doing. So the somatic part of dance, I'm not diving deep, deep into some of the things that you might get if you were in an academic setting where you were studying somatic dance. But what I would like you to think about is what you feel like, what you're aware of while you dance, and the places that bring you joy, the people that you can dance with that bring you joy. And if you have to be online, the fact that you can connect with your friends and you can share dance together, you can see each other's rooms, you can see each other's hallways, you can laugh about some of the crazy things that we have to do because of our restrictions. But you can also celebrate dance in a way we've never been able to celebrate before. And that is with finding the joy and finding what feels so good for you. Why do you dance? Do you like to spin? Maybe you like to lift your leg. Maybe you enjoy the splits. All the things that really make you enjoy being a dancer and wanting to express yourself with dance. So I'm hoping this episode inspires you to think in those terms and allow for that richness that comes out of dance particularly when we have restrictions, because dance carries us forward and it helps us to heal, helps us to de-stress, helps us to find calm, peace of mind so we can sleep well. Dance is a catalyst for so many things, and the arts is just so incredibly important for what we're doing. We want to use our dance now like we've never used it before and then celebrate it. And so I'm hoping that's what this lesson is going to inspire you with. And that leads us to the last little bit of topic, from special occasions into personal growth. I just want to make sure I have everything that I noted down. So your personal growth, that is what dance is all about. Yes, you're going to gain skills. Yes, you can be technically proficient. And yes, you can dance to your favorite songs. Mostly, you want to find what makes you happy. And if dance makes you happy, go for it. Enjoy the rest of the lesson. I hope you have fun with the ideas I've created this time. Hi, as you reach this part of the lesson, you're now to the place of the peace flags. So the flags actually have started out in the Himalayas, and people use them to put their wishes into fabric with either writings, etchings, drawings, paintings, photographs that have been put on. But what they do is they create the flag with an intention. They create it with a goal that they have or a wish that they have. And a lot of times it's for peace around the world. That's what they're really striving for. And once the flags are done, they're strung up so they do not touch the ground. They are up into the air and they blow in the wind. And once those flags are hung, they blow until they're tattered and torn and they disintegrate. And what happens with that is the belief that as the fabric lets go, as all of those strings let go, your wishes are being granted by the wind. The peace flags we created for our dance program this year as a pilot project. And the dancers each painted their own flags and then hung them out. I hung mine on the full moon for Halloween, which is a blue moon. It was a special time for October 31st. And some of my dancers put them up for Remembrance Day in honor of those people who have served for our freedom. So as I invite you to think about perhaps maybe you want to do a peace flag, you can dance as you think about how you want to put that painting together or that idea together. You can dance as you're creating. You could dance and paint with your feet if you wanted. And then what I want you to think about is, what kind of dance could you do outside as you go to hang them in the trees and give them the possibility of the wind to have those wishes granted? And as you bring all of those ideas forward, see how movement, dance, music is all going to be a part of that process and that goal setting that we have. And as you embark on that project, if that's what you choose to do, then just know that you have a winter that you'll be able to look out at those flags and watch them and watch those wishes being granted. I wish you the best. Have fun. If you've made it to the end of the lesson and you're seeing me now, you'll have watched four different videos. You'll be looking and thinking about a lot of different ideas. This is a jam-packed lesson. But what I want you to think about now as you've reached the end of the video is the video you watched about the ballerina who just was so passionate about what she was doing. Now she has flexibility like many of us will never experience, but she had a passion to share with us. And I love the video for that fact. And what I want you to think about now is how you use your passion to practice, how you use your passion to create, how you use it to express and to solve life's little challenges for yourself through dance, and make it one of your mediums that you can go to when you need a place to be that's safe, that's calm, that allows you to de-stress, that allows you to just have a peace of mind that you can then create or think and be able to solve some problems. Just what is the role that dance can play for you in the joy that it brings? And I wish you the best as you continue to bring dance into your world and share it with others. Thank you for staying through to the end of the lesson. I appreciate the fact that you've been here and you've experienced it. And it means a lot to me that you're here. Thank you.